We have traveled 3,000 light years to come to your planet. We are here to solve all your problems, including climate change and COVID-19.
We all need your help. Climate change doesn't exist,
and as far as I know, we have a cure for COVID-19. It's called hydroxychloroquine,
in case you haven't heard of it.
But your doctor said it doesn't work.
We don't care what our doctors say. Leave all of it now.
We have created something that can get rid of COVID-19 in just 3 days. We are ready to share our technology with you.
We are ready to share some of our technology with you as well. We have 5,000
nuclear warheads, all pointed at your spaceship. If you don't
leave our orbit within the next 30 seconds, we will be forced to fire.
Perhaps we shouldn't have come here.
I agree. Prepare to leave orbit. This planet is a lost cause.
Excuse me, what's happening?
It looks like we have consumed our entire budget for the visual effects.
Are you saying we can't finish this movie?
I'm afraid so. I mean, we don't have money.
But we didn't get to the best part yet. You know, the part where hydroxychloroquine cures COVID-19?
Spoiler alert. It doesn't cure COVID-19, Hashim. Did you even read the script before coming here? Now, what kind of an actor doesn't know what's happening in the movie that he's starring in? You're supposed to do your job with that bug.
Now, the bubonic plague.
A suspected case of bubonic plague was reported on
Asian giant hornet.
Giant hornet.
Called the murder hornet.
The use of a decades-old malaria drug had been approved.
The emergency use of some forms of the chloroquine drug.
Hydroxychloroquine is already available. It's been used to treat malaria and arthritis since the 1950s.
So far, in laboratory studies, chloroquine has shown promise for the prevention and treatment of SARS, a close cousin to COVID-19.
In March 2020, the world officially introduced its first answer to the COVID-19 pandemic. In order to understand the logic behind using hydroxychloroquine against the coronavirus, we have to take a look into how it works. The drug doesn't directly interact with the virus itself. Instead, it disrupts the environment in which the virus replicates. Inside the host cell, the virus requires acidic environment to make copies of itself. However, when hydroxychloroquine gets into the cell, it reduces this acidity, making it difficult for the virus to replicate. Hydroxychloroquine was also believed to calm down your immune system during viral infections. After you get infected with the coronavirus, several immune cells are recruited to the site of infection. This process is called inflammation. But since viral infections can sometimes be severe, your body recruits even more immune cells than it should. Eventually, large groups of immune cells assemble into the site of infection, where they begin attacking your own healthy cells. Hydroxychloroquine was believed to reduce this overdrive of the immune response.
But first, hydroxychloroquine is making headlines again tonight after the FDA warns doctors the drug is too risky to treat coronavirus patients.
There's a warning from the Food and Drug Administration about a medication that many were looking at as a possible cure.
There's a new warning this morning about anti-malaria drugs being used to treat coronavirus.
The FDA Monday revoked its permission to use hydroxychloroquine as a COVID-19 treatment, saying the potential dangers of taking the drug were greater than the possible benefits.
The Food and Drug Administration says hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine could cause dangerous disruptions in heart rhythm.
After reviewing research available on the drug, the FDA concluded it does not meet the statutory criteria for emergency use authorization.
There are a number of reasons why hydroxychloroquine didn't work for COVID-19. First of all, the initial study that showed positive benefit was based on lab tests. And as you know, what works in the lab might not always apply to real life. The benefit might not translate from animal and cell models to humans. Think about it. In lab tests, you're examining the drug on individual or cluster of cells, whereas inside the human body, tissues and organs work together as a complex machine. You are ignoring hundreds of thousands of processes that may render the drug unsuitable for use. Not to mention, the physiology of animals is different from that of humans, which makes it difficult to obtain the same results in inside the human body. And this happens all the time. You spend 10 years developing a drug that would prove effective for a certain disease under lab conditions, but when it comes to human testing, it might not work, and you have to start over again. The second reason why it didn't work was its chemical structure. This is the chemical structure of hydroxychloroquine when it was first announced, and this is its chemical structure today. As you can see, nothing has changed. Normally, if an existing drug shows benefit against an emerging disease, scientists can improve on it by modifying its chemical structure. As far as we know, no one has made any modifications to hydroxychloroquine to improve its efficacy, which means the way it works inside the body hasn't changed. So, if it didn't work in yesterday with its old chemical structure, why would it work today with the same chemical structure? Drugs don't magically adapt to the virus. In other words, you can't expect hydroxychloroquine to change its structure on its own to end this pandemic. In order to improve its benefit, hydroxychloroquine was tried in combination with azithromycin, yet the results were still not good enough to make it a standard treatment, which brings us to the third reason as to why it didn't work. Remember, not all COVID-19 patients are the same. The medical history of each patient is different. Plus, some of them are using existing medication that could interfere with the effect of hydroxychloroquine, leading to serious complications instead. Not to mention that our genes play a vital role when it comes to responding to the same treatment. People tend to forget that our genes are essential in our response to diseases in general, which is why women were less affected by COVID-19 in comparison to men. Then you have different stages of COVID-19, from mild to severe. All in all, expecting hydroxychloroquine to be a one-fits-all solution to every COVID-19 patient didn't make any sense. And this was reflected by the results of clinical trials. The final reason why it didn't work was highlighted in a recent study, which investigated what hydroxychloroquine does to COVID-19 patients. It turned out that hydroxychloroquine was actually blocking the activity of a certain type of white blood cell called monocytes, which play a role in the first line of defense against infections. These monocytes can develop what's called trained immunity, a nonspecific type of memory that allows your body to react quickly to viral and bacterial invaders. Since hydroxychloroquine blocks the activity of monocytes, the virus ends up winning because the first line of defense has been compromised.